मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू टेक्सचुअल क्वेश्चन आंसर्स फ्रॉम चैप्टर नंबर 3, फिजियोग्राफी एंड ड्रेनेज. नंबर 1, कंप्लीट द सेंटेंसेस बाय चूजिंग द राइट ऑप्शंस. नाउ ए, ब्राजील इज कवर्ड मेनली बाय डैश हाईलैंड्स, प्लेन्स, माउंटेनियस रीजन और डिसेक्टेड हिल्स. And the answer is highlands. Okay. B, like Brazil, India too has dash. And the answer is ancient plateau. Okay. Second one. C, the Amazon basin is mainly dash. And the answer is covered by the dense forest. So it is third one. Fourth one. Amazon is a large river in the world. Near its mouth, dash. So, no deltas are found. So, it is second one. No deltas are found. Amazon is a river, large river in the world. Near its mouth, no deltas are found. E, the Lakshadweep island of Arabian Sea are coral islands. Okay, so coral island is here, second one. Last, to the foothills of the Aravallis dash, and the answer is Malwa Plateau. So this is lies the Malwa Plateau. It is third one. Number 2, answer the following questions. A, differentiate between the physiography of Brazil and India. You can write, this is a question A1. So answer, the physiography of Brazil and India can be differentiated with the help of the following points. Number 1, the physiography of Brazil is divided into the highlands, the great escarpment, the coastal region, the plain and the island groups. The physiography of India is divided into the Himalayas, the North Indian plains, the peninsula, the coastal plains and the island groups. Second point, there are no high and long extending mountains in Brazil. On the other hand, there are many high and long extending mountains in India. Third point, the Himalayas mountain range extends in the northern part of India. Similarly, the mountainous region of Western Ghats is in the west and the mountainous region of Eastern Ghats is in the east of the peninsular region of India. Fourth point, the highest range of altitude is 500 meters to 1000 meters in Brazil. On the other hand, the highest range of altitude is 6000 meters to 8000 meters in India. Fifth point, the western part of the North Indian plains is occupied by desert. On the other hand, no such hot desert areas lies in Brazil. Sixth point, many wide plains are located in the north and in the coastal areas in India. On the other hand, there are no wide plains in Brazil. Seventh point, at many places there are regions of backwaters in India. On the other hand, there are no such regions in Brazil. Now, eighth point, the great escarpment is located in the northern part of the Brazil. This great escarpment demarcates the eastern sides of the Brazilian highlands. On the other hand, no such escarpments are located in India. Number 2 is, what measures are being taken to control pollution in the river of India? Answer is, the following measures are being taken to control pollution in the rivers of India. Point 1, controlling the discharge of human sewage into rivers. Second point, applying sufficient and appropriate pre-treatment to the industrial effluent waste before being discharged to the sewers. Third point, displaying hoardings informing tourists not to pollute water of rivers and highlighting the importance of cleanliness. Fourth point, removing solid waste from rivers and applying other rivers cleaning processes. Then, question number 3, explain the characteristics of the North Indian plains. Is the characteristics of the North Indian plains are as follows. Point 1, a flat low-lying areas is located in the north of India. This region is known as the North Indian plains. Point 2, the North Indian plains lie between Himalayan mountains in the north and the peninsula in the south. It extends from the states of Rajasthan and Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. Third point, the North Indian plains are divided into 3 parts. Fourth point, the low-lying areas to the east of the Aravallis is known as Ganga Plains. It slopes to the east. The delta of Ganga Brahmaputra rivers extends in the state of West Bengal in India and Bangladesh. This region is known as Sundarbans. Sundarbans is the largest delta region in the world. Sixth point, the western part of the North Indian plains is occupied by desert. It is known as Thar Desert or Marustali. The state of Rajasthan is occupied by Thar Desert. Seventh point, the plains of Punjab lies to the north of Thar Desert. It is located to the west of Aravallis and Delhi ranges. 8th point, the plains of Punjab slopes to the west. It has very fertile soil and therefore agriculture is highly developed in this region. Now question number 4. What could be the reason behind the formation of swamps in the extensive continental location of Pantanal? And the answer is, the following could be the reasons behind the formation of swamps in the extensive continental location of Pantanal. Point 1, Paragaw River and its tributaries flow from the Pantanal region. Second point, Pantanal receives runoff from the Brazilian highlands. Third point, the sediments brought by Paragaw River and its tributaries get deposited in the low-lying Pantanal region. Fourth point, the sediments and erosions residues as well as water remains filled throughout the year in the Pantanal region, leading to formation of swamps. Now question number 5 is, which are the major water divides of India, giving examples? And the answer is, the major water divides of India are as follows. Number 1, Himalayas, Aravalli Range, Vindhya Range, Satpura Range, Western Ghats are the major water divides of India. Second, for example, Western Ghats separates the west flowing rivers meeting the Arabian Sea from the east flowing rivers meeting the Bay of Bengal. Third point, for example, Vindhya Range separates the Ganga drainage basin and Narmada drainage basin. Fourth point, for example, Himalayas separates the rivers flowing in the Himalayan system from the rivers flowing in the Trans-Himalayan range. Question number 3, write short notes. Number 1, Amazon river basin, Amazon river basin. So you have to write this short notes in points, okay? So point wise we are going to write. Point 1, Amazon river basin is the largest plain land of Brazil. It lies in the northern part of Brazil. The slope of Amazon river basin is to the east. Second point, the width of Amazon river basin is the maximum, that is nearly 1300 kilometers in the west. Its width is the minimum, that is 240 kilometers. Where the Guiana Highlands and Brazilian Highlands come closer. Point 3, as the Amazon River approaches the Atlantic Ocean, the width of Amazon River Basin or plain increases. Fourth point, Amazon River Basin or plain, you can say, is covered by the evergreen tropical rainforest. Most of the areas of Amazon River Basin is inaccessible due to dense undergrowth and frequent flooding. Okay, and children, this answer is there on the page number, you can see here, page number it is 19. So this answer is here also. Okay, so you can see textbook, you should read the textbook for the answers. Himalayas, this one. Okay, so answer you will write point wise. Himalayas, point number 1. Himalayas is one of the young fold mountains in the world. It extends from Pamir Knot in Tajikistan in the west to the east. Himalayas is one of the major mountain systems of the continent of Asia. Point 2. In India, Himalayas extends from Jammu and Kashmir in the north of Arunachal Pradesh in the northeast. Himalayas as well as many other parallel mountains ranges get included in Himalayas mountain system. Shivalik is the southernmost mountain range of Himalayas. It is the youngest mountain range of Himalayas. Third point, as we move from Shivalik's range in the south to the north, we come across lesser Himalayas, Greater Himalayas and Trans Himalayas ranges respectively. These ranges are young to old respectively. Fourth point, the Himalayan mountains ranges can also be divided from the west to the east into Western Himalayas. So in bracket you can write or Kashmir Himalaya. You can close the bracket. Central Himalayas, in bracket you can write Kumaon Himalayas, and Eastern Himalayas, Assam Himalayas. Okay, the coast of Brazil, third short note is the coast of Brazil. So point, you can write point 1, the coastline of Brazil extends for approximately 7400 kilometers. It is divided into the northern coast and the eastern coast. Second point, the coast extending from Amapá province in the north to Rio Grande do Norte is known as the northern coast / North Atlantic coast. The coast extending from Rio Grande do Norte to the south is known as the eastern coast, South Atlantic coast. Third point, northern coast is a low-lying region as Amazon and its many tributaries flow to the northern coast and meet North Atlantic Ocean. Marazo Island, Marazo and São Marcos Bays lie on this coast. Marazo coastal island lying on the northern coast is located between the mouths of River Amazon and River Tocantins. Fourth point, many small rivers flow to the eastern coast and meet South Atlantic coast. São Francisco is the only major river meeting the South Atlantic oceans in this region. Many beaches and sand dunes complexes lies on the eastern coast of Brazil. In some areas, the eastern coast of Brazil is protected by coral reefs and atolls island. The Indian Peninsula. The Indian Peninsula, point one. The Indian Peninsula lies to the south of North Indian Plains. This region tapers towards the Indian Ocean. Second point. Many plateaus and hill ranges are included in the Indian Peninsula. The Aravalli's range is located in the north of Indian Peninsula. It is the oldest mountain range in the Indian Peninsula. Third point. The Indian Peninsula also includes a series of plateaus bordering the plains. Maharashtra Plateau, Karnataka, Telangana Plateau, Chota Nagpur Plateau and etc. are the main plateaus in this region. Fourth. Vindhyas and Satpura ranges are located in the central part of the Indian Peninsula. It also includes mountainous or hilly regions of the Western Ghats in the west and the Eastern Ghats in the east. What is the Great Escarpment? Point wise, again you are going to write point one. The Great Escarpment is the smallest physiographical region of Brazil from Sao Paulo to Porto Alegre. The height of Brazilian highlands or plateau decreases remarkable, leading to the formation of Great Escarpment. The Great Escarpment demarcates the eastern side of the Brazilian highlands, or you can say plateaus. Second point, the altitude of Brazilian highlands is approximately 790 meters in the region of the Great Escarpment. In other regions, its height decreases gradually. Third point, the nature and the slope of the Great Escarpment affects the climatic condition of Brazil. It acts as a barrier to the southeast trade winds. Fourth point, the Great Escarpment leads to heavy rains in the Brazilian coastal areas, and it also gives rise to the rain shadow areas to the northeast of the Brazilian highlands. These rain shadow areas known as drought quadrilateral. Number four, write geographical reason. So number one is there are no west flowing rivers in Brazil. Okay. And the answer is here also means every time you have to write point wise. Okay. So first point, this is give reason and we have to write point wise. So first point is most of the rivers in Brazil originates from the Brazilian highlands. Second point, the altitude of Brazilian highlands gradually decreases from the south to the north and from the west to the east. As it affects, most of the rivers in the Brazil flow towards the northern and eastern direction. Third point, the rivers flowing towards northern direction meet the North Atlantic Ocean, and the rivers flowing towards eastern direction meets the South Atlantic Ocean. Thus, there are no west flowing rivers in Brazil. Two, there are dissimilarities between the eastern and the western coast of India. And the answer is, point wise we are going to write, point one, at places spurs taking off from the Western Ghats have extended right up to the western coast. As it affect, the western coast is rocky in nature. Second point, the width of the western coast is comparatively less. Westward flowing rivers meeting the Arabian Sea from estuaries and not deltas on the western coast. Third point, on the other hand, the eastern coast of India is formed due to the depositional work of rivers. The width of the eastern coast is comparatively more. Most of the eastward flowing rivers meeting the Bay of Bengal from deltas on the eastern coast. Thus, there are dissimilarities between the eastern coast and the western coast of India. 3 is there are fewer natural ports on the eastern coast of India. Point 1. The eastern coast of India is formed due to the depositional work of eastward flowing rivers meeting the Bay of Bengal. Most of the western coast of India is a coast of submergency. On the other hand, eastern coast of India is a coast of emergence. As its effects, the sea is deeper in the west than the sea on the eastern coast. Third point, westward flowing rivers meeting the Arabian Sea for estuaries at many places on the western coast. On the other hand, eastward flowing rivers meeting the Bay of Bengal from deltas at many places on the eastern coast. As it fades, it becomes difficult for ships to reach the east coast covered with sediments. Therefore, there are fewer natural ports on the eastern coast of India. This last question, this one is fourth one, give reason 4. So, as compared to Amazon, pollution in the river Ganga will affect human life greatly. And the answer is, the density, point 1 you can write, the density of population in the Amazon river basin is comparatively low. Second point, the number of industries is also limited in this region. As it affects the level of the water pollution of Amazon river is comparatively low. Third point, the density of population in the Ganga river basin is comparatively high. Many industries have flourished in the Ganga river basin, leading to increased water pollution. Therefore, as compared to Amazon, pollution in river Ganga will affect human life greatly. Question number 5. Identify the correct group. A. The order of physiographic units in Brazil while going from northwest to southeast. Okay. So, number 1 is given. Paraná River Basin, Guiana Highlands, Brazilian Highlands. Second one. Guiana Highlands, Amazon River Basin, Brazilian Highlands. Third one is given, Coastal Plains, Amazon River Basin and Brazilian Highlands. So you have to find out from these 3 options. So you have to find out the correct ones. And the correct answer is this B1, Guiana Highlands, Amazon River Basin and Brazilian Highlands. Okay. Question number 2. These rivers of Brazil are not flowing rivers. So answer I will say directly, and the answer is Zuraika, Ingu and Aragua. So this is first one. Order of plateaus of India from south to north, and the answer is number 1, that is Karnataka, Maharashtra and Bundelkhand. Okay, you can do this as activity. Okay, you can draw by yourself if you don't have your India's map. If you don't have, so you can draw this map at home, and you have to mark the following on that map. Okay, so what you have to mark is number 1, Western Himalayas. You will mark there Western Himalayas. Second one is Eastern Himalayas, you will mark. Third is Punjab Haryana plain. Fourth one is Thar Desert. Fifth one is Western Coastal Plains. Sixth one is Western Ghats. Seventh one is Eastern Coastal Plains. And eighth is Eastern Ghats. Okay. So what do you have to do? You have to draw this map if you don't have map at home. And then you have to write these names on that map. This is your homework. Okay. You have to do this. I'm going to see. Only this map. Completed our textual question answers. Okay, children, so you can start learning that question answers.